Hey everybody, welcome back to Sarah Sarah.
How's it going, everyone? Based on the title, I'm definitely going to put timestamps down below. So
the usual.
We're going to talk about the Netherlands squad just a little bit because, you know, love, romance.
Love is in the air. Oh, yeah.
So we're going to talk about that. But we're also going to talk about the actual game that just happened with the Netherlands versus Switzerland. So we're going to talk about that as well. But, you know, a little Dan and Ellie talk going on.
Deli? somebody ordered a deli meat platter because I want a few of those.
I wonder if that deli meat is in other countries or if that American term, deli meat.
Ooh, let us know down below.
Okay, so what we're going to talk about. Sarah and I have been enjoying the Euros. Sarah, we have been watching a game every single day. And now it's official. The quarterfinals are all set. It is decided who is in the quarterfinals. The group stage is done. But we wanted to go back to Team Netherlands because as we talked about in last video, you know, there's a lot going on with Team Netherlands. Viv still out. The game against Switzerland they played, she is still out. Jackie Groenen has returned to the squad. And if someone left a comment the other day saying Viv had mild symptoms. Mm. And I think everyone who gets COVID-19, it's a little bit different for everyone, you know? So we watched that game going Netherlands, Switzerland. And going into that game, Netherlands had to tie up until about the 83rd minute. It was a nail biter. You know, I didn't watch it. Sarah actually knew the score when we were watching because we watched it on replay.
I accidentally saw the score, the final score on Instagram.
But we were watching it and up until about the 84th minute. But going into that game, I mean, Switzerland could have easily won that game. There was a few opportunities in that game.
At first, I thought they were going to win. And then I looked at the score. And then I said, oh, no, they're not.
Yeah, in the 13th minute, Switzerland almost went up. They were coming out fighting. And Ramona Bachmann, we've talked about her a bit on our channel, but she looked great. She looked great out there. They really were getting her the ball a lot.
She was putting her life on the line.
She
was putting her body on the line.
She was when she free kicked.
Oh yeah, well, quite literally, she laid down.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know how she ended up in that position.
Yeah.
She drew the shorts.
That was so funny. I forget what minute that was, but I haven't seen. Maybe that's a pretty common play, but I've seen it
in the men's game.
Oh, have you? A lot of the commentators were talking about Lieke Martens didn't look great. Jill Roord didn't look great. Sarah, I'm gonna be honest. I thought Switzerland was gonna pull it out. I thought they were gonna win, and I don't want to think that, but I thought they were gonna win. I thought they were going to pull it out. There was a penalty kick that was almost called against Switzerland. And they, on the field, it was called penalty kick. And then they overturned it. And the commentators at that point said that was the right decision. So we saw a VAR work for the good of soccer. In the 49th minute, there was an own goal by Switzerland. And that was a really heartbreaking own goal. And so that put Netherlands up. Then 3 minutes later, the Swiss scored. So, I mean, it was...
They equalized.
Yes, just 3 minutes later. Going up until the 84th minute, it was still 1-1. At that point, I was just like, it was a nail-biter. I said, who's going to win? There were some great saves on both sides, though, I will say.
And it was very exciting to watch.
Some of those...
On the edge of our seats.
Yes, some of those saves by the keeper, the Netherlands keeper, who still only has 5 caps or so. She looked great, you know. Yeah. What I mean? And then the keeper on the Swiss side also, you know, they weren't messing around. Then in the 84th minute,
Netherlands scored.
So that at that point you're like, okay, it didn't look good for the Swiss because the Swiss had to beat them. They couldn't just tie. So it didn't look good. Then
in the 89th minute,
they scored again.
Yeah.
And then in the 90th plus 5, they scored again. So, I mean, it was pretty much over. I did feel, you know, as much as I was rooting for the Netherlands, I still felt bad for the Swiss. I, you know, if they would have won, I was rooting for the Netherlands, but the Swiss look good. I like Leovalti. I like Ramona Bachmann. I like, they have a good, great team. It wasn't to be, but like I was telling Sarah, I'm like, the Netherlands, you know, people were saying a couple players didn't look great. You know, if they want to go out there and win the whole thing, they got to look better if they want to win the whole thing.
Right.
Also, like we said, Viv wasn't playing. You know, do you think Viv was at home kind of like, do you think she turned off the game? Do you think, sometimes you get nervous and you don't want to watch a game.
I don't know. I think she watched the game.
Quarterfinals are set and it's going to be on Wednesday, the game. England-Spain is going to play. Then actually, Netherlands don't play till Saturday. They're going to play France, which I think will be a very, very tough match for Netherlands. But back a little. Let's go back a little in time. If we remember the game before this game, they played Portugal, and that was a big match too. One of the biggest highlights of that game, winning goal basically, was DVD. She scored that amazing goal. And but before that, let's talk about that. We know that DVD and Ellie Carpenter have pretty much made it official. I mean, as official as you can make it before you actually say it's official. And a lot of people, before Euro started, you're like, is Ellie Carpenter going to be there? Are the WAGs going to be in attendance? That's always the question. And we got our answer, pretty early on, I would say.
WAGs come through.
So we found out pretty early that Ellie was there supporting DVD and Team Netherlands. And as we see this picture, she has her orange kit on. Mm-hmm. Just being a WAG. I love it. Posted this picture on her Instagram. And actually, Team Netherlands posted this on their official Twitter or Instagram. But they posted a picture of Shanice's up in the stands. And look, you can see right there behind her. That's on the official.
Yeah, Ellie's right there.
Yeah. So we know Ellie's there. So she's there supporting her bae. But if we go back to that game where DVD scored that winning goal for Team Netherlands, we remember she did these hearts. And we're like, look at the hearts.
It's like a bat signal, but the hearts.
Yes. And, she was doing the hearts. And then, a lot of people said, oh, I wonder what the hearts are for. Is it for just winning, just happy, whatnot?
For the fans or whatnot.
Exactly. So there was this interview on the show called, it's on YouTube, it's called,
I got this, Liu Winning on Tour EP number 2.
Which I'm not sure what that translates to. I'm sure it translates to the Netherlands on
Something
tour.
Something winning.
Winning on the tour.
winning.
It's like them. It's like the Netherlands is doing like a documentary style during the Euros, talking about the Euros and everything, and on their YouTube channel, just talking about the Euros and winning. So they're interviewing all the players and whatnot. It is in Dutch, so
I can translate for you.
So there is this part with DVD, and she is being interviewed by this interviewer, but she's asked this question, and there is translation on the YouTube. It will auto translate for you, but I found this on Tumblr where someone translated it, and I'm going to borrow what they said. So thank you to this person on Tumblr. The interviewer asked him about that heart.
So the interviewer asks, at some point a heart went into the air too. That was not for me, obviously, but who was it for? Look, it was for everyone I love, basically, put it that way. My parents were there, obviously, and my girlfriend was there. It was really a coincidence, too, with Farrah Williams. She's an English legend, and I'm still in contact with her before the match against Sweden. She told me that if I scored, I should do the heart. So I take that it was a little bit for her, too. But, yeah.
So she said specifically, my girlfriend was there. Officially, she says, my girlfriend, Ellie Carpenter. She basically officially says, my girlfriend.
Yes.
So I think that was really sweet for her to say that, and yeah, A, to just do the heart, and she's so proud. I mean, they're so proud of each other. Ellie being there, being so supportive, and there's a couple other WAGs that we're going to talk about coming up, but they're so supportive, So I think that's super cute her to acknowledge that. Obviously, it was for the friends and for Farrah Williams, but for also for her girlfriend.
And for family, but yeah.
Family. So what did everyone think about that? What does everyone think about Ellie being there, being supportive? I love it. And also, going back, not to bring up Beth Mead, but we're going to bring her up because still, always, whatever Danielle's been posting about doing well at the Euros or Euros, and Beth Mead has still liked everything. So
friends forever.
Exactly.
Make me start singing it.
Quarterfinals are happening. We haven't talked much about England. So far, their run has been they've pretty much gotten by all their opponents. Mm-hmm. Pretty easily, I will say. Sometimes that can be a hindrance, though, in the long run, where you don't have the really hard matches. But Netherlands play France next. It's going to be tough. 100%.
Yeah, for sure.
Also, we're going to bring this up, too, right now, just because we're thinking it's on my head. But, a lot of people have saying, when are you guys going to talk about Ingrid and Mappy? When are you going to talk about them? They're a couple. Some new photos have just come out. that are pretty hot and steamy.
It's happening, guys. It's happening, everybody. It's happening.
And I will say, Sarah and I had not... We'll talk about this in the video that we do about it, but Sarah and I really didn't know much about Ingrid or really Mappy at all.
But it turns out I have a new crush, okay? It's okay, Sarah allows it.
But during this Euros, we watched Norway play, unfortunately, they crumbled, but we saw them play. And we have been watching Spain. So we've really watched more of them in the last 2 weeks than we've ever seen them play. So now we have more to go on about who they are, what they're all about. I know they both play for
Barcelona,
but we're going to do a video about that. So look out for that video, especially if Spain wins. If Spain wins, oh my gosh, what does everyone think? Who do you guys have? The quarterfinals are here. The next game is on Wednesday, and that's England-Spain. Who do you have for England-Spain?
England.
I have England too. I want them to win. If Spain wins, I would actually be happy. I'd be fine with that. But I want England to win, obviously.
Yes.
Questions, comments down below. What does everyone think? We'll talk to everyone later. Have a great night. Bye.